Yeah, I know I'm a little bit late on this topic, but I wanted to make sure that there will be no more news on these new laptops that they have announced at the CES 2021. So let's talk about those. So what's up? It's always me, Johnny, and today we finally talk about the new products that are coming out this year, and probably, if we are lucky, maybe in the first quarter of this year. So as you may know, at the CES, many tech products are just presented, but on this channel, we are going to see only the most interesting one. And in specific, we are gonna take a look on the new laptops that are coming this year, because those are the things that are most interesting to me and probably to us too. So we're gonna see that. And also, I'm gonna try to answer the question that I'm receiving on my channel and under my videos. That is, should I wait for the new laptops presented at the CES? Or maybe should I buy just the new MacBook with the M1 chip? And also, remember that I'm not a big YouTuber, so I do not have any engineering sample of any laptops right here with me, because nobody wants to send me a free laptop right now. But I'm gonna just tell you any info found on the internet, and also I'm gonna tell you what I think on these new products. So first of all, we are gonna say that there are two most important things that are very interesting and that there will be on the new laptops this year. The first thing is actually the new NVIDIA GPUs, so the 3000 series with the RTX technology, as we already know, that will of course increase performance, but also they just increased the heat dissipation, so there will be maybe a fix in the temps and maybe in noise, who knows, and also more performance on the RTX side for those who use them. I do not use them, first of all, because for now I think they are just useless. And second of all, I just have all my devices with AMD GPUs, so I cannot use that. And also, they will be more useful to people like me who edit videos, or maybe they play some heavy games. Number two, and this is the most interesting thing that they have presented, or maybe that they have just showed at the CES, the new AMD CPUs series, so the 5000 series, and those CPUs will bring just some fresh air to the gaming laptops, because for now we had only gaming laptops with Intel CPU based, and so we didn't have so much competition between the two in the laptop side. But as we saw last year with the 4000 series, we saw like great performance on the laptops and great thermals, and also those laptops came just at a great price, so the offer by AMD was very good last year. And this year, of course, it will be better because the performance are very much increased. Also, AMD says that the new CPUs are just consuming less watt per hour, so we just got an increase on the battery side of these new laptops, and this is a great thing. But one thing that I'm worried about is just that AMD knows this market, and so probably this year they know they have potential in the market, they will increase the price of these new laptops. But for now we don't know any price of any laptops, so we just have to wait and see how it goes for the price. One thing that I'm hoping for is that with these new AMD CPUs we just got some good performance, but most important, as I said before, and as they claim, there will be an improve on battery life side on the laptops, because with the M1 chip from Apple this year, we just saw an improvement, a big improvement on battery side. So I'm hoping for this new laptop that they have like similar battery life, or maybe more if they can, but I don't know about that, because they are very, very performant laptops. So I don't think they will be just better than the Apple M1 chip, but if they can get close to that, I will be very happy. Also, there are more factors that we have to consider, like these laptops have like dedicated GPUs, the RTX 3000 that I mentioned before. With the combination of the two, the battery will probably go down very fast, but I'm hoping if you use the laptop like for browsing and just office work, I'm hoping that it will last at least close to the M1 chip from Apple, because now I'm just too used to this laptop battery that is just never ending, and so I'm hoping for a closer results from AMD. because I just want to test these new laptops. I want to see their performance. That will be great because with Windows, we don't have any optimization problem for any apps. So I can use like Premiere Pro without any problems or any other heavy apps because these laptops will be just very powerful. Instead, if you want to talk about what laptop in specific we have to take a look on, personally, it's just some laptops from Asus. As we already saw last year, Asus just presented the G14, the Zephyrus, I guess, always in the ROG lineup, so the gaming laptops, a 14-inch laptop with AMD CPU, and it was great with a great price. Also depends on what markets are you. Of course, if you are in the USA, the price will be just better, like maybe if you are in Europe like me. And also the availability of the product, it will be very much different. But this year, Asus presented a refreshed lineup from the last year laptops and also presented some new ones with the AMD chip and some others with the Intel chip. Also this year, they had presented the G14 with this new AMD chip, and so I will take a look on that, and as soon as I know something, or maybe I can just pre-order on some website, I will do that because I want to try that device. I'm just very interested on that laptop. Also, if you are interested too on that laptop, or maybe if you use like a 15-inch laptop and maybe you are interested on that, they have presented also a 15-inch version, so you can just go for that. Of course, as I said before, we don't know any price, any date, so we have to wait and see when they come out. But I repeat, as soon as I know something, I will do a video on that and maybe we will try that in this year. Other than this new and refreshed laptop from Asus, they presented a new 13-inch model, always in ROG lineup, so the gaming laptops, and they presented this 13-inch that is called Flow. And actually it's interesting because it can be connected to an actual external GPU that is like very small compared to the older version of other manufacturers, but this time it doesn't connect to a laptop with the Thunderbolt, and so it's connected by a proprietary connector from Asus, and so it can deliver all the power from the GPU to the laptop. It's not like the Thunderbolt, because with the Thunderbolt the performance were not at 100%, so now with this new technology you can just deliver all the performance from the external GPU to the laptop. That is, I repeat, a 13-inch, so if you are interested to that. And personally, I just never trust, we can say, in the external GPU for the laptops, because I prefer to have like an all-in-one device. If I want to just travel around or maybe go around with my gaming laptop, I don't want to bring with me just an external GPU to take care of. But for those who are interested in, I think it will be a good thing, and if Asus will make this work, I will be pretty surprised about that. So these were just a few info of the new products announced at the CES, and also I can do more videos on this topic, but these were the most interesting things for me actually, so I just wanted to do a video on that. And also, going back to the first question you asked me in the videos, that is the Mac versus the PC. So if you have to wait for the new PC that they have just announced right now, or maybe you can buy just an M1 chip right now, just the MacBook Pro that I have right here. And the answer is very simple actually, because first of all, if you use Windows, and if you are used to use Windows, and if you like Windows, you just use any program with Windows and you want to stick with that, just wait for the new laptops, because as I said before, they will be very powerful laptops, so just wait for those. There will be many improvements on these new devices and it will be very worth it. But if you want to try the macOS experience, or maybe you just want to switch to Mac because, I don't know, you have an iPhone, you have AirPods or stuff like that, and you want to give it a shot to Mac, just try the new M1 chip Macs, because they are very good. Also, if you are using for office work, if you are just writing, or maybe if you are gonna use your laptop for web browsing, these laptops are great because, as I said before, battery life is incredible, so it's just a perfect laptop because it's just 13-inch, so very portable, as I said in my previous videos, and I don't think you will have any problem with those new laptops. But I repeat, if you are using Windows, I think you should not ask yourself this question and just wait for the new laptops. But anyway, I think this video is getting too long, so if you have any question, just type it down below in the comment section. And also, thank you for your time. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, just hit a like right now. And if you haven't subscribed yet, just consider subscribing right now so you won't miss any content on this channel. And that's it. So I will see you in my next videos. Bye for now.